This video is on the topic of electric charge. Atoms are made up of protons, neutrons, and electrons. Protons and neutrons are found inside the nucleus, and electrons are found outside the nucleus. Remember that electrons are negatively charged, protons are positively charged, and neutrons are neutral. Atoms have an overall neutral charge because there are the same number of protons and electrons in an atom. When electrons are transferred away from an atom, there are more positive charges left than negative ones, and so the atom becomes an ion and it has a positive charge. When electrons are transferred to an atom, there are more negative charges than positive ones, and so the resulting ion has a negative charge. This is a concept that students often find confusing. Remember that gaining negative charge makes an atom or object more negative. When charged particles interact, they follow two simple rules. Like charges repel. So two positively charged particles brought into close proximity will experience a force of repulsion. The same goes for two negative charges, such as electrons. However, two oppositely charged particles, so one positive and one negative, will experience a force of attraction. These forces are non-contact forces because they act at a distance. The unit for measuring charge is the coulomb. Let's take a look at an example exam question. A student holds a charged plastic rod near a running tap. The student observes the stream of water bend towards the plastic rod. Which of the following shows the correct arrangement of charges in the stream of water? In each of the diagrams, the rod is negatively charged. Water molecules are polar. That means that they have areas of positive and negative charge. You don't need to know that, but that's how this phenomenon actually works. So we need to choose the diagram that best represents what would happen if a negatively charged rod was held close to the stream of water. Now, we know that opposites attract, and diagram A shows like charges attracting. So that can't be correct. And same goes for answer option C. B is showing a pretty equal spread of positive and negative charges. So that's not really showing attraction or repulsion. So we can also discount B. D is showing positive charges attracted to the negatively charged rod. The presence of the negative charges has caused the water molecules to move so that the positively charged areas are closest to the rod. In this diagram, we can see that opposites are attracted. So the correct answer is D for 1 mark. In summary, charged particles are either positive or negative. Like charges will experience repulsion, and opposing charges will experience attraction. When atoms or objects gain electrons, they gain negative charge, and therefore they become more negative. They become negatively charged. When atoms or objects lose electrons, they lose negative charge. Therefore, they become less negative. They become positively charged. Don't forget to check out all our other fantastic revision resources here at Save My Exams.